So I wrote down a bunch of David's quotes.
Good.
And this man
Good.
Had not only, you know, brilliant, warm, and giving heart, but he was hilarious and incisively funny and witty.
To some.
Yes. To some, he could be brutal. We had people leaving that room and leaving the business.
He was always right.
And he was always right,
and
exactly. And it was always, the other thing that was always extraordinary was the people and several people that worked with the in the classes. I should preface this by saying I took David's class after he had moved to LA and been there for a number of years. He had a heart condition and his doctor said, "Go west, young man," and or old man or middle-aged man. And Hal Prince and Joanna Merlin, his casting director at the time, and Stephen Sondheim all spoke to him and said, "We're holding auditions in New York, and these actors do not know what they're doing. So please come back." And so Linda and I and Cindy Burgoyne in the audience, I don't know who's any, who's there?
Jeff Becerra, how are you?
Jeff Becerra, how are you?
Great to see you.
All were in the very first group. Lonnie Price was there with us. Rosie Harris, Dina Merrill, and we were all in this first group that he, this first new New York group, because he had been in New York for a number of years before that. They came for, I think, was it 4 weeks or 8 weeks or 4 weeks? And he was at the West Side Arts Theater, and, oh, actually, Cindy, you joined us later, I think. You joined us
later. No, I was in the, you know, the Punning and Archer building.
Yeah, so you went one year after that. So I would go there and just watch day after day after day after day. He let you, if you were in any of his classes, mm-hmm. you could audit everything. And I just watched and watched and watched. And in my class, and I can't remember if you were in my class or the other. Well, one thing, he started us out, that year he was not teaching his subtext class.
Right.
He started out, because that was the second class, so he started out with technique classes and a master class.
Mm-hmm.
And if you were a real working actor in the city and out of the city, he put you in the master class.
Yeah, you'd just get up and sing.
So we did not, we sort of started out bass backwards,
right.
Because we started out in the master class, and only later in our development did we do all the ones, twos, threes, all this wonderful subtextual work that can guide body language so brilliantly. But anyway, so there we were, and I was watching and watching, and in our class, you had to give Gary Carver, who was the musical director, who was his right-hand man, we put our music on the piano when we were ready to sing, and so like the second class, I put my music on the piano and didn't get called. But I'm still watching all the other classes, so after another class, I'll go home at the end of the day and shift my song based on what he had been talking about mm-hmm. that day. And then the third class comes along, and I put my music on the piano, and I don't get called. So I go home, and I'm still, you know, shifting my song and adding in things about the focus, about bass changes, which was a technique he taught, about working ahead with your body, ahead of the lyric with your subtext rather than on the lyric. And so I was trying to make all this work, and I came in and I sang for David, and I looked at him, and he said, there was this pause in the room, the silence, and he said, "Why are you here? Because you teach what I do." And I said, "I've been just watching." And of course that thrilled him, because so many people were complaining about not being able to work, and he went around the next week saying to all the classes, "Somebody just watched and she gave a performance of my work." So eventually what happened for me was that David's class came to me and asked me to teach him in his absence.
Oh my gosh.
Which was just one of the, what was the turning point in my life, because I was just an actress I was an actress and singer, and never saw myself in that light, except in the groups that we had created together to keep the work going. So to say a theme, I think, for all of us has been the ways that David changed our lives. And for me, it was dramatic because I'm still teaching those techniques to this day. I just one thing before I just read some of his quotes. I've been asked by the wonderful Tova Feldshuh, who was a student of David's, and who I directed in her one-woman show, Tova Out of Her Mind. And Pam wanted me to talk about that a little bit, just because it was the experience of two people working together with a common sensibility and a common vocabulary, because we had both worked with David. And I just can recall when I directed her in Craig Carnelia's Just a Housewife. And it was magic for both of us. It just was this elevating day that left us both, you know, flying, because there was such quick and easy communication based on our understanding of this brilliant, brilliant work that David gave us. So Tova has sent me this note to read tonight, and she just said, "It is my loss not to be with you, as the reason I was chosen for the benefit has a lot to do with the extraordinary David Craig who trained me." So that's from Tova. I'm going to read just I have a whole bunch more, but I'm just going to read like four of his quotes, of some of his things that he said and some of his techniques and stuff. And then if anybody wants to catch me afterwards, I'll be happy to go through this little book and tell you a whole bunch more. The first was, singing, like sex, requires that you make sure the other person, the audience, enjoys it as much as you do and has an orgasm too. That's David. And he said, and this goes along with what has been said already today as well, 1/3 of my teaching life is spent teaching people not to sing. And this is a phrase that I use in my classes a lot, so some of you out there may recognize it, but it's pure David. A good nothing is better than a bad something.
Mm-hmm. I've heard him say that.
But a good something is better than a good nothing. And finally, just to close, this is a comment I just found that it brought me to tears. He said, the Buddhists say that in your last life you come back as a teacher.